family operation started by my father in 1982. I bought a local herd and mixed grades and purebreds, and we worked our way up. Nancy and I took over the main operation in 2003. Dad gave us opportunity, and our children have worked with us, and it's been a real family affair.
In 1991, my parents purchased a cow by the name of Caranda Matador Rhea from a herd in our county. She today accounts for about 30% of the animals in our herd. Her most notable descendant to date is a cow, Mill Valley Bolton Borneo. She's excellent 94E with 9 stars. Another cow we're particularly proud of is Mill Valley Final Cut Fiona. She calved in January with her 10th calf. She's classified 95-7E and has over 120,000 kilograms of milk. She has 4 milking daughters in the herd and 7 granddaughters.
Today we're milking between 60 and 65 cows in a tie stall barn. One thing that's important to us, the cows go outside every day and in the summertime to pasture. The dry cows and heifers are raised in bedding pack, loose housing. The current herd consists of 15 excellents, 38 very good, and 14 good plus, with a BCA of 250, 290, and 265 for protein. Because when it comes to breeding here, we try to keep things pretty simple. We strive for very functional, balanced cows that are high in components and trouble-free, and hopefully have the capability of a long, productive life. Dad's always used the best bulls he could at the time, and we followed through with that approach. And I think a couple tools that have been very important to us over the years since the beginning are both the Holstein Canada classification system, as well as which now is lacked in that DHI. In the early years, when our cattle knowledge maybe wasn't as high as it is today, it allowed Dad to know the weaknesses and strengths of the herds and make sound breeding decisions. And also, even now, we're breeding kind of our top third of the herd to sex semen and the remainder to beef. So it's an unbiased opinion that can kind of help us guide us. Each generation you're trying to improve, and if you're not improving, then there's a problem with your breeding or management. So it really allows us to make sure that we're trending in the right direction.
As far as mentors go, we'd like to recognize Paul Cole. He was an Eastern Breeders technician, and he took us under his wing when we were pretty green in the dairy business. And he was also a kids 4-H leader, and he's been a great leader and for us, and a great friend as well. Also, a great source of mentorship has been all the farmers that our children have visited in their careers. They've been all over Canada, and people have welcomed them onto their farms. But they've come away with an idea and a story from every one of those farmers, which they've brought home and shared with us, and we want to thank them for that. Yeah, I just want to give some advice to young breeders that if they're aiming for a Master Breeder Shield, don't think they have to spend a lot of money to get there. We weren't able to, and we just worked our way up. And just, there's good cattle that are so affordable right now that you don't need to break the bank to get some, and really take your time and look at it that way. And I also want to tell young breeders that don't be afraid to ask people questions. When we started, we were pretty green as well, and we had to ask all kinds of questions, and we're still asking questions, and there's so much good information out there.
For our family to receive a Master Breeder Shield has been a family achievement, and it wasn't until the kids were in 4-H and they started looking at better cattle and that we all got interested, and the kids pushed for classification and that we'd do the mid-rounds and everything, and over time we saw the herd getting better and better. And so it's just been, it's been a process all along, but it has involved everyone, and we're all grateful.
I think for me, the Master Breeder Shields, it's special for mostly seeing Mom and Dad have worked so hard over the years. They've spent 40 years of their lives trying to get here today, and so it's just really nice and rewarding for them.
Receiving the Master Breeder Shields, a very happy and proud moment for everyone in the family. With dairy farming today, especially on family farms, there's a lot of early mornings, long days, and it's nice that at the end of the day to be recognized for breeding the type of cow, the Canadian cow that people want. It's a really proud moment for the family.